Good old Nintendo Power. Man, those were the days. And with the first 100 shots of Zelda 64, before it was known as Ocarina of Time. That should be interesting. Love me some good beta shots of games. Nice, we have some Diddy Kong Racing in here too. There we go. Look at that. Skeleton models of Stealthos. Link's first shots of battle. Dongos. Goma. Man. The world wasn't ready for what this was about to unleash upon it. Good stuff. Man, that was a... The fuck is this? Chameleon twist. So, you use your tongue? Like Yoshi? But no, you can, like, pole vault and attach to poles and what? I mean, it looks like a decent enough platformer. It's got some good variety to it, I guess. Is this covered in any previous issue? Madden 64? Oh, jeez. Diddy Kong Racing? Tamagotchi? No. This just came out of nowhere. Well, it's... Let's take a look at that then. So, from the folks that brought you the Blaster Master series, Fester's Quest, and the perennial purveyors of licensed Looney Tunes games, comes this odd little sleeper for the Nintendo 64. Released alongside classics of the year like Diddy Kong Racing, GoldenEye, and Star Fox, to name a few, Chameleon Twist continued the tradition of following in Super Mario 64's platforming stead. To set itself apart from the platformers of the day, the shtick here is the use of your chameleon's tongue to eat, jump, and twist your way through six drug-inspired levels. Sorry, but there's no real other way to put it. This game is drugs. Don't believe me? Well, let's sift through the character selection screen here, and I will pick the completely ripshit stone guy to help prove my point. The game starts out with you in the blandly named Jungle Land. I know, not generic enough. Where we find the Mad Hatter shows up. Naturally, he is late for tea, and there's no time to waste. He makes his way over to the rabbit hole down to Wonderland, leaving his massive cauldron of highly potent LSD unsupervised in the middle of the forest. Naturally, your chameleon makes his way to the edge and dives right on in head first. Timothy Leary, eat your heart out. Thus begins your 6-hour long trip through the wilderness, an ant colony, a WMD processing plant, Castles made of sand. The peak of your hallucinogenic experience. And the eponymous bad trip. Throughout the game, you'll need to use your tongue in ways that set a new standard far beyond I can tie a knot in a cherry stem. From pole vaulting, scooping up more enemies than Yoshi ever dreamed of, giving your back hole a little tickle, okay, that's not necessary, and rotating around poles. Seriously, this thing is the muscle of the gods. I can't even cross monkey bars with my arms, and this thing is supporting its weight with its massive 10-foot tongue alone. You'll find levels are riddled with this game's arbitrary collectibles. Crowns. For some reason. The only purposes they serve are to unlock Boss Rush, bragging rights to tell your friends you 100%ed Chameleon Twist, and the looks on your friends' faces when they wonder what the hell Chameleon Twist is. The platforming is initially insanely forgiving, but does ramp up towards the later stages, testing your mastery of spinning and fighting with one of the worst cameras I have ever had the misfortune to deal with. Luckily, like the crowns, your health and life system is entirely 100% arbitrary. If you die and get game over, you just restart the room you're currently in with all your crowns up to that point, and your health meter at full. Once you reach the boss in the ghost castle, that's it. The game's done. The rabbit's acid wears off and you realize it was all drugs the entire time. Told you. The enabler that he is, the White Rabbit thanks you for being his trip buddy, and invites you to chase him again should you feel the addiction setting in. And that's it. 6 stages, no real risk of any danger since lives are entirely meaningless, and at the time this would have set you back $60. That's $10 per level. I mean, it's not terrible, but it's not $60 good. Though it did do well enough to garner a sequel. If you see it out and about in your travels, it's certainly unique enough to at least give a pickup. Just don't expect anything past an introductory 3D platformer with very little replay value. That does it for this episode of The Gamer's Den. I am Den, and I feel the strange need to try and lick my elbow.